So this video is about a downloadable game called Asia Booty, which I played on the PlayStation Network, or got off of PlayStation Network. And Asia Booty is often classified as a pirate-themed naval strategy game, but I find it a bit hard to agree with that classification. The pirate theme is interesting, I guess, but the extremely simple mechanics makes me wonder. Strategy? I mean, what strategy? Of course, even without the strategy, the game offers a lot of fun, but it does ultimately and negatively affect the game's longevity because there is no strategy. The premise is to direct your main pirate ship on a map comprised of hexagon grids to capture towns located on coast and islands. Only the main pirate ship can be directed, and ally ships are either AI-controlled, I mean in single-player challenges, or directed by your PSN friends in online multiplayer. So you control just one ship at a time. And the controlling the ship just amounts to moving the pointer with your right analog and choosing which hexagonal grid the ship should move to. The game only requires and only allows this control setup, since the ship automatically detects enemies located on adjacent hexagonal grid. The only thing that's a little bit complex about this game is that, with resources gathered around the map, you can direct the ship back to the main cave, kind of like your headquarters, to upgrade the ship's speed, armor, or firepower, and each of these aspects can be upgraded up to 3 times. With enough resources, the towns you capture can also be upgraded to have stronger defenses. Resources can be collected by destroying enemy ships and moving over to the wreckage, destroying islands with raw materials, and by capturing towns which will accumulate resources over time. So there are tons of ways to make resources. The best way to, of course, is to capture towns and to have resources accumulate over time. There are also pirate cards you can pick up by destroying neutral and AI-controlled ships, which act as special powers, allowing you to create hurricanes to teleport the enemy to a faraway place, or placing a bomb that blows up after a few seconds, or turning invisible unless attacked. And that's pretty much the game. I don't know, if my explanation sounded complex, it really shouldn't be. It's really just like, you know, you have a hexagonal grid, you move your right analog stick to point to the where you want to move, you click, the ship moves there, and the ship will do automatically attacking for you, and you just have to direct your ship to places, and then you go back to the cave, and then you choose which to upgrade, speed, firepower, or ammo, or armor, right? So that's the game, and it's very basic, and none of the 21 single-player challenges featured they don't add anything more to this premise. Some have time limits, some include multiple enemy factions to fight against, but every single one of them is about capturing towns on maps that feature the same caves and the same islands and the same coasts. So visually, everything kind of looks the same. And so it's fun for a while, but with the game limiting your decision to just one ship, so there's no strategy, the feeling of repetition can sink in rather quickly. And further on, the more difficult missions will make you wish that you can somehow issue commands to the AI-controlled allies, because they often decide to do really stupid things that can make you lose the battle. So that's the most frustrating thing, is when you lose a battle not because you did something wrong, but because your enemy AI-controlled units went over there and did not help the cause, did not help the battle at all. The most fun to be had is in the multiplayer component of the game, especially if your teammates are willing to communicate with you and work together using a headset. The problem, though, is that the good online teammates are actually pretty rare, and now that this game is extremely old, good luck with that. And what's more, after a couple of matches, the fact that you can only direct your own ship where to go quickly makes this game into a click-and-watch type of game, rather than a game actually requiring teamwork and strategy. By the end of the day, you'll have some fun, but the game will eventually turn out to be much too simple, and you probably won't care that the game has a map editor feature. Because after all, no matter how different the maps are, it really doesn't change all the experience that much. It really doesn't change the strategy, because there is no strategy, right? So overall, the game is fun for a while, but its extremely bare-bones approach to the strategy gameplay really totally kills any replay value there is to be had in this game. Honestly, I do not recommend this game at all. I don't know, some people might enjoy playing together with other players online, because there really isn't, not that I'm aware of, a game that's like this on PSN, or maybe even on Xbox Live Arcade. Age of Booty is also an Xbox Live Arcade. It's just that I happen to play it on PSN. So that's my thoughts on this game.